So I got a question for you. If I'm building out a pack and I know it's 4 in series and I know I'm going to go 40 in parallel, do you say the parallel first? So is it a 40P 4S or is it a 4S 40P? I don't know. Hey guys, this is Frank. This is the DIY Engineer Channel. Today we're going to continue to cover our talk of this battery pack right here. This is a 4S 40P. So we're going to build 3 of these and they're going to be replacements for my portable power pack. We've been doing this upgrade because I'm taking my portable power pack from 2.2 kilowatts, I said kilowatts with a K, to 4 kilowatts. Hey guys, this is Frank and this is the DIY Engineer Channel. On this channel, we do things like batteries, and we also do things like house projects, building, construction. I want to do some concrete countertops. I've done quite a bit in the past, and I'd like to show you guys some of my techniques and how I do concrete countertops. The other thing we're looking forward to doing probably this summer is starting work on an electric vehicle. I'm hoping to take a older model Mazda Miata and pull the engine on it and actually put a bunch of batteries in it and some motors and see if we can get it to go. Anyways, so if you like this channel, if you like this kind of stuff, subscribe below, subscribe, and then hit the little bell dong so that you get updates whenever I publish something. So also I have a questionnaire, just a real brief question. It's going to be right up here. If you wouldn't mind just taking a minute answering the quick question. Let's just select one of the items. And with that, we're going to go talk about this 4S 40P battery. Let's go do some soldering. We're going to do some soldering so you can see how I did the soldering for this particular pack. I know soldering, woohoo, yay. And we'll chat a little bit on the backside. All right, let's go.
So previous to doing this, I went through and I cleaned off all the tips of the cells. And after cleaning the cells, then I tinned every one of them. Meaning I put some flux on them and then added globs of solder in preparation for putting the fuses on. And you can see here I'm actually attaching the fuses to the tops of the cells. And this is kind of a tedious process. Some of these cells don't like to take solder, so it takes a little bit of work. But then after I get them on there, this is a close-up of what the cells, the fuses look like as they're attached to each of the cells. The next thing I have to do is I have to clean off any grit and grime off of the bus bars, and then I slide the bus bars underneath the fuses, and then I just work the fuses down over the top of the bus bar so that it lays something like this, gets it in there nice and snug. I don't use any glues or hold the bus bar in place because the solder itself will keep it snug. Haven't had any issues with that. So once the bus bar's in place, then I just go back on the top side of it and I start working on the soldering of the backside. So I solder each of the cells on the backside so that they can connect to the opposite side. Then once I do this piece, once I complete soldering the fuse to the second side of the bus bar, then I come back and I'll actually solder directly to the bus bar. So it's quite a bit of soldering. I think to do this one side of the cell pack took me about 2 hours. So it is kind of tedious, and you're only going to see just a few minutes of it. So there's what the bus bar looks like after the fuse has been soldered to the bus bar and to each of the cells. Then later on, what I'll do is I'll put cross members between the cell packs. So the lower section there are positive, and then the other cells above are negative. We'll just tie them together.
I hope that was helpful in seeing how I kind of did the soldering process on there. I know it's like a lot of stuff going on, but you know, it is what it is. And there are a couple of you, and you know who you are, I hope, who have commented and I haven't responded. And you've actually written me emails and I haven't completely gotten back to you. And it's partly because I'm just like slammed, really busy, and end up working like, yeah, I'm sleeping about 5 hours a night. So plus doing this, working full time, there's just a lot going on, but that's okay. That's not your problem, it's mine. And I will I will get back to you. Just so you know, all these red cells are for my power wall. We're going to be going to the power wall. We're going to be doing power wall stuff here real soon. Well, I'm hoping within the next couple of months at least, because I'm ready for it. I'm ready to start powering my house. Also looking at some solar solutions. Now, one of the things I didn't point out when I first started this channel, I didn't point out why I'm doing battery storage or why I'm doing power storage. I wanted to do solar. I wanted to put solar panels on my roof. Everybody around me is doing it. You know, it's kind of the end thing. But you know, when it come down to it, I couldn't justify putting panels on my roof and then giving that power back to the power company. Yeah, I got a reduced rate, but at what cost? 30, 40 grand? Not worth it. So what I wanted to do was actually build my own way of storing power so that I could use it at my leisure. So I could use it at night. I could run off of my solar panels during the day, use my batteries at night, and be able to have the ability to be really almost off the grid. And there's, in some cases, I will get to that point. I will get to the point where I'm off the grid. But for now, I'm doing Powerwall. And so to get to Powerwall, I didn't know enough about batteries. I'm probably like some of you who didn't experience or have a lot of experience working with batteries and building these kind of kits. And so I decided, hey, I'm going to start small. So I made small kits. You know, I know 2.2 kilowatts is actually quite a bit, but they're smaller. It's smaller than, you know, a 10 kilowatt Powerwall. So now that I've had a chance to learn, I'm sharing, but I'm also going to go and do my Powerwall. And I would encourage you, if you have even just the ability to put together, you know, 100, 200 cells, build something small, something that you can learn from, have some experience, do some, you know, short circuiting stuff and watch sparks fly. And anyways, so do it. You can actually do those kind of things. And I would encourage you to do it. It's a good experience. You learn a lot and you do a lot of reading. And yeah, you can watch a lot of me, but I'd actually encourage you. You can watch a lot of me. I don't care. But that's why I got into this, is I want to go solar. I want to be self-sufficient. I want to be on my own, doing my own thing, and not necessarily drawing power from the grid. And I didn't think it was wise for me to put up solar panels before having a way to store it. Because right now, I built the house that we're living in, and I built it with all LED. Every light bulb in my house is LED. And in that process, my power bill is about $100 a month. We're talking 4,000 square feet at $100 a month. So I actually got a pretty good rate on electricity. And I can't, if I go and put, you know, $30,000, $40,000 of solar on my roof or in my yard, it's probably going to cost me more than that. Because sometimes I've had these solar companies come in and they say, hey, we'll make you a really good deal. You know, we'll just take your power bill and we'll, you know, you'll just pay like $10 less than you have been. And that's going to be your payment with interest. And I would never pay it off. $100, that just would go forever. So that's really not an option for me. So what I did is I opted to go batteries first. Once I have my batteries in place and all the solar panels up, and then I think it'll be, I don't know, pretty smooth sailing. I hope. I don't know. I haven't done it, but that's what I'm doing right now. And you say, well, Frank, those batteries are expensive. Well, you know what? Take a look here. I got this on a deal. And in that process, I went through, I've gotten all of these for under $2,000. I'm less than $2,000 in batteries. And I did that because I looked for deals. I went out and hunted, packed, found. I grabbed laptop batteries, tore them apart. You reskinned them, a bunch of stuff. Actually, all of these red cells are brand new. They're all new. And I got them for less than $1 a cell. So you can find those deals, but you gotta look for them. And I think that's sometimes the hard part. And yeah, when I wanna grow my Powerwall, it's gonna take more cells. I'm gonna have to buy more cells. And I'll probably end up spending $1, $1.50, $1.25, I don't know. I don't like going over $1.25. I don't like going over $1.25 for replacing cells. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. And hopefully you're doing that too. All right, so with that, I'm gonna end this, and hopefully the information in this video has been helpful. Again, if you like it, please subscribe below, ding the bell. That way there you'll know whenever I publish something new, you'll be able to get updates. And with that, we'll catch you next week. Thanks for watching. Okay, so let's go back and rethink that.